Hi everyone. So today we'll be discussing everything about teething, and I will also be busting some myths and stating some facts regarding it. Now, the very first thing that comes to the parents' mind is, when does the teeth come? And most of my patients' parent come to me with a complaint that my child doesn't have a teeth yet. So, my dear friends, we need to understand that there's no ideal age or a specific age wherein the teeth will come in all the children invariably. No, that's not the case. We usually have a time period. The most common time when the teeth come in a newborn child, or let's say the first set of tooth, that is commonly called as milk tooth, or in scientific notation we call it as primary teeth. It usually erupts by 6 to 8 months of age. But in certain children, it can either be seen as early as 4 months and as late as 14 months. Yes, you heard it right. It can come as late as 14 months. And if we talk about the permanent teeth or the secondary teeth, then the time period in which it usually erupts is 6 to 7 years of age. But in certain children, it can be seen as early as 4 years of age and as late as 9 years of age also. Okay, so now we know the basic time range in which the primary and the permanent, that is your milk teeth and your permanent teeth, erupt. If there's a delay of even more than what I've mentioned, then it's quite worrisome. You need to take your child to the dentist. Now, we'll be discussing here the related symptoms. Now, please emphasize this word related. Why, you'll get to know later in my slide. Related because these are the symptoms which actually happen because of eruption, and it's most severely seen in the first set of dentition. That means when your milk teeth are erupting. It's not that commonly found when you have the second set of teeth coming, that is your permanent teeth. And when basically the first time the tooth is coming in a child's mouth, that is the time when these symptoms are at their best. That means the peak of this is seen. And usually what is seen is restlessness, and the child is quite fretful. He'll be having or she'll be having too much of saliva in his or her mouth. Then you'll see loss of appetite. If the child is still feeding, then you'll see that he or she is feeding quite less. Or the child will even want to put finger in her mouth or in his mouth. Then you'll be seeing, in certain cases, you'll be seeing a change in color of the overlying tissue. That means, supposedly, if you're having the upper front teeth erupting or the lower front teeth erupting, you'll see some change in color. There'll be some redness and there'll be some pain and swelling in that area. Although these last two symptoms are not that commonly seen, but in, let's say, 20 to 30%, it can still be seen, so do not worry. Okay, so we got to know the problem, that what usually happens. Now, what needs to be done? The first thing that needs to be done is use a teether. And you should be very careful that you always keep the teether clean, right? Just wash it with normal water or either soap. But be careful of rinsing the soap properly. There shouldn't be any soap remaining on the teether. So, rinse it properly because that's going to go into your child's mouth. You can use a teether. Then you can even use a cold spoon, like you get those plastic spoon with no sharp edges of children specifically. So you can use that also. Keep it in freezer or fridge for some time and give that to your child, and he or she can bite on it, and that's quite relieving. Or you can even give some cold carrots or cucumbers. Okay, but you have to be careful and see that the child doesn't bite it and the child doesn't get choked because of that. So you have to be careful with these. Otherwise, the teether and the cold spoon, they're fine. So if you can notice, teether, cold spoon, cold carrots or cucumbers, these are basically given why, you know, whenever you have your teeth erupting in the mouth, it causes a lot of irritation, basically itching sort of a sensation, and you get relieved when you clench or when you rub something or when you scrub something on your gums. It provides relief in that area, and that is why these teethers and cold spoon or cold carrots and cucumbers, they help in providing some sort of relief in that period, right? And it also is quite psychological that if you rub that area, you will be relieved. So both ways. The fourth point that I've mentioned here is be watchful of what goes in your child's mouth. This is the last point that's very important, because to relieve that itchiness that's happening in their mouth, they end up taking anything and everything around the house. And then they have all the problems that I'm going to be mentioning later, and that is why I mentioned about the related symptoms first, because now what I'm going to be talking about next will be the unrelated symptom. Okay, but before discussing the unrelated symptoms, we need to know that what does not need to be done when your child is having such a problem. Please, all of you, I request all of you to do not use any kind of anesthetic ointment to relieve that sensation of itchiness, because those anesthetic ointments have got local anesthesia in them, which enters into your blood and has got various effects on all your organ systems. So just to relieve that natural process, please do not end up doing something that is more harmful to your bodies. Now we shall be talking about the unrelated symptoms. Why unrelated? Unrelated because these are not related at all with the teething process, but it is coincidentally found together or along the teething process. Like croup, that is your normal coughing or bronchitis, if you can say, that usually happens. Then you can see diarrhea, you can see fever, you can see convulsions. That means that rigorous movement of the hands and the feet, or sometimes in children, the child just faints. So that is also a kind of convulsion. Then you see a lot of incidents of infection, and then primary herpetic gingival stomatitis. This is a kind of herpetic, or I can say a viral infection, that usually occurs in that age group of around 6 months, and it's coincidental to be found in that teething period, but people usually relate to the teething process, and that is why I've mentioned it in the category of unrelated symptoms. And even death, because in 19th century the infant mortality rate was high in the teething period, and people would consider teething to be a cause of the death of the child in that period. So these are all the symptoms that usually are unrelated but happen or are coincidental with the teething process. Okay, so we read that fine, these symptoms are coincidental, but how is it that at this time only we have so many symptoms? That's because what happens is, I've already mentioned before that the child ends up taking everything that's lying around him or her. So when you take anything in your mouth, obviously that's been loaded with bacteria and the dirt. And all that dirt and bacteria or whatever kind of microorganism, when it enters your body, the body starts reacting, right? If it enters your respiratory tract, that means your airway, obviously you will have cough. This is a preventive mechanism of the body to push anything that has entered inside, anything and inadvertent basically that has entered inside your airway, the body tries to push it out by coughing. Then like diarrhea, obviously if it enters into your gut, the body tries to flush it out. Then if you have fever, obviously fever is also an indication that there is an infection, or any kind of infection also for that matter, if it's happening. So all of these symptoms are basically happening because something inappropriate has entered into the child's system, and now the body is starting its mechanism to push it out or throw it out or excavate it out, basically let it out of the body. And that is why this is basically the end result of having anything in the child's mouth, by the child itself, of course. Then also because the eruption of the teeth, it's a very, very normal physiological process. That means it's a normal process of the body. It's programmed in the body. It's not a new thing that is happening for which the body will start reacting. And that is why the association of all those symptoms, all those unrelated symptoms that I've mentioned before, their association is just not justified. So this was all with regards to teething, and these were the basic questions that I get on daily basis from parents. But there are certain things that are more to it, and I'll be making a part two of it soon, wherein some complications are also seen in few cases. So what needs to be done in that case, I shall let you know. Till then, happy teething, take care, and if you like this video, do give it a thumbs up. And if you find it informative, then do subscribe to this channel. Take care.